In this video, we're going to do a head-to-head comparison of Mocha versus Lovable. Lovable recently released something called Lovable Cloud, which turns it into an all-in-one platform where the backend is integrated. But Mocha has always had this functionality. So what you need to know is which tool is better as an all-in-one platform. While this video is sponsored by Mocha, this comparison was recorded in one take and it was my first try. So the results that you are going to see at the end of the video are the genuine head-to-head results. Let's jump in. So we're going to test Mocha on the left versus Lovable on the right with the exact same prompt. And we're going to see if the new Lovable Cloud, which allows you to have the backend and user authentication built into Lovable, is able to beat the all-in-one platform that Mocha has. Mocha has always had the ability to have user authentication, the backend and the database all in one, whereas Lovable just added this to their products. I want to see which one actually wins. So to do this, we're going to do a fair test and send the exact same prompt on Lovable and Mocha. So I went ahead and sent the prompt. The prompt is to build a SaaS time tracking app. We want to include user login and a database to track everything for the user, which is where the backend and authentication is going to come in. And then to make it even more complicated, I'm saying I want team functionality built into the database. So right off the bat here on the Lovable side, it's asking me to enable cloud. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, which is then going to have it be an all-in-one platform. On the Mocha side, the AI is saying it's going to build the SaaS tracking app. It's going to start with the core features of user login, time tracking, project management, and team collaboration. And it's starting by setting up the authentication system and database schema. So it's not even asking me to set up the backend. It's just going to go ahead and do it. So on the Lovable side, it is telling us what database schema was created. And we can see here, it's actually using Supabase as the backend, but it's just basically doing it for you. Whereas Mocha has it all built in natively with the backend. So it's not using Supabase. So now it's building the app with a professional design system, and here Lovable is working. And then over here, it looks like we're close to getting our first version on Mocha. It says it successfully built it. It has a landing page, Google auth, timing functionality, project management, and a dashboard interface, and a proper database schema for teams, projects, and timed entry. So we're going to jump into the database and everything in a second. It looks like it's just putting the finishing touches on our app before we can see it. Okay, now both of them are ready for us to test. It actually did both at about the same amount of time. So in terms of time, that is pretty much a tie, but the most important thing is the actual results and the quality of the results. So let's start here with Mocha. Now I like that Mocha created a landing page for us. So it's not just a login, which it looks like that's what Lovable did. So Mocha actually built out a whole landing page. And then what we can do is test it out by clicking Get Started Free. And it's going to prompt us to log in and actually create an account. And Mocha does this with Gmail by default. So we're logged in. And I like that it has a Gmail authentication, or sorry, Google authentication as the login. That just makes it really easy for users. So it's cool that it did that by default. So now here in the actual app, it looks like we have a timer, we have projects, and then we have reports, but there's nothing to report yet. And let's check it out. Let's try it. Let's create a project. So the project could be YouTube video editing. Let's say I was a video editor. I wanted to track my video editing, create the project, and then we're going to go to the timer. And I'm curious to see when we do this in Lovable, how it compares to Mocha. So let's say we are creating a thumbnail. And let's start the timer. So now we have a timer going. It's tracking creating a thumbnail. It's within the project. And let's stop it here. So then if I go down, we can see now that time entry is saved. Now it's 0 minutes because we didn't do it for a full minute, which makes sense. But then now if I go to reports, still looks like reports isn't there. So maybe we have to add that on in a minute. If I click on the user profile, that's not quite there either. So on the front end, this is all I see right now. We're going to add some features pretty soon. If I go real quick into the data table, we can see there's the projects field, and that's starting to fill in data already. Something that's really nice about Mocha is that you have a development and a production database. So once we publish the app, we're going to have that separated, which is nice. You're going to have all of your data in development mode, and then you can have a full separate database in production, which is really the best practice to do that.
Then under memberships, it looks like it has teams and team memberships, kind of the schema. The schema are the fields available. So those are ready to go, but we're going to have to actually prompt it to build out that feature. Time entry. So here we go. We have our first one, and it does have the duration in seconds, which was 9 seconds. And then users, that's our user. So before I start building on and adding more features, let's check out Lovable and compare it. Here we are. Again, I think that Mocha wins on the landing page. I really like that it created a landing page for logged out users instead of just showing this login feature. Again, you could ask Lovable to do this, but it didn't do it on its own. So I like that in the first prompt, it was just a little bit more built out and polished. So go ahead and create the account. And again, one of the differences here is that it's not a Google auth. It has to be email and password. So just another difference there between Lovable and Mocha. Then we can go ahead and let's see what features we have. So we have just comparing the UI. Let's compare this to the UI here. I'll let you decide. Let me know what you think in the comments, which UI is better, at least on this first version. Then let's say we're working on video editing. So we'll do the same thing. Actually, let's start a new project real quick. So we'll say video editor and we'll do red. And it looks like right off the bat, it does say failed to create project. So there was an error there. Let me just try a different color to see if that makes a difference. No, I am getting an error. I can't create the project. Try one more time. Nope. So I'm getting an error. So right off the bat, there were no bugs or errors on Mocha. I am getting an error here. Although it does look like it created. So let's see if I can create a team. This was something that also getting failed to create team. That also is not working. Oh, I just saw actually down here, there is a build unsuccessful. So maybe that's why it's not working. Let me just click the try to fix button and see if that changes anything. Okay, and here it looks like the database tables were not created. So we're going to have to try this again. It's having me click it again. So hopefully this time it works. And once this is updated, we'll test out the functionality again. And then we're going to add some more features. All right. And now it's saying the database was correct. So now we have to fix some security warnings. So just overall, this is taking quite a bit longer on the Lovable side than the Mocha side, at least for this first version. Okay. Now I'm getting another error. The migration partially failed because some tables already exist. Let me check what's in the database and create. Okay. So it seems like it's working correctly now, or at least it says it is. So let me try refreshing the page. And I am logged in. And now let's try creating a project again. So it'll be YouTube editor. And let's create the project. So now it says project created, but it's not showing up here automatically. Let's see, maybe if I refresh the page, it will show up. And no, it is not showing up. Let me try this one more time. YouTube editor, create the project. So it's not showing up. Let me check the database. So if we click on cloud here, we can actually check the database, and it does look like under project, there's two rows. So that's good, but it's not actually showing up in the front end. Small error there. I'm sure we can prompt it to try to fix it later, but why don't we just test a simple thing to just see if it works. Let's just say editing videos and click start. So now it says timer started. At least now we are getting this timer, and let's pause and then hit stop. I do think there's the pause option. Now under recent time entries, still not showing up. I wonder if I log out and create a new account, if that's potentially the issue since it was created before. Let me try that real quick, and then we're going to jump back in. Okay, so now I'm on a brand new account. Let's create a new project. And okay, still getting the same exact issue. All right, we are getting some more bugs here on Lovable and Mocha. Mocha all did it in one shot on the first try. One shot means one prompt, and then it goes. Lovable, on the other hand, we are getting some bugs. So I'd like to finish this with a reporting feature and see how each does. Mocha on the left, Lovable on the right. So the prompt I'm giving is to build out a tab for reporting to add really beautiful reports on time tracking. So I'm curious how each of these is going to compare. So Lovable has finished the reporting. So let me go to the reports tab, and it looks like pretty basic. Let me just start a timer and see if it saves. That was something that we were having issues with before. So I'm gonna stop and let's see in the reports if it's added. So it's not. So what I'm gonna do, Mocha is still working. Let me just prompt Lovable again and try to fix this error. So the prompt I'm giving Lovable is when I save time tracking projects or teams, it doesn't show on the front end. So reporting is also empty. So it says it sees the error and we need to modify the database. So let's see if that actually solves it. And meanwhile, we can check Mocha to see how it looks. So it says it did it. You can also review the actual code changes. You can see There were 4 files changed, 1 package installed, and you can undo it if it doesn't work well. So if we go to the reports tab now, here we go. So it is working correctly. We have the data pulling in, and I really like the charts that it created. And then it also has some insights, which is interesting as well, that it built that out. So cool. I like the reporting tab here. It seems to be working. And again, everything with Mocha has been working on the first try. And then now here on Lovable, it says it fixed it. So why don't I refresh the page? And if I go to reporting, it's still not showing. So go back to time tracking. What am I working on? Let's try this again. Video recording. And let's start it. And then let's stop. And then let's go to reports. And it's still not showing up. If I go to the cloud and go to the database, I do see it's being saved in the database, but it's just not being shown in the front end. So I'm going to say it's still not showing. I do see the data saved in the database, but not showing in the front end. So it's asking me to modify the database again. So it says it thinks it's fixed now. Let's try one more time. And yeah, okay, so now I can see at least it is showing up. We have our project showing up. That bug does seem to be fixed. Let's go to reports. So that is showing up, at least with the data coming in. And again, I'll let you be the judge. Which design do you like better for the reporting tab, the Lovable side or the Mocha side on the left? So I'm going to stop there. I don't want this video to go on for too long. I think the overall summary here, Mocha, even though they are the video sponsor, I really did this in one take, and it looks like it was able to do it without as many issues as Lovable. Lovable had a lot more issues I had to go through, especially with the database and the cloud. So if we're just especially comparing the Lovable cloud versus Mocha and its all-in-one capabilities, Mocha definitely had an easier time. Let me know again what you think in the comments. Check the link in the description if you want to build with these tools and do it on your own. And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.